Good morning to one and all. Today our topic is practical and detailed view of OGSA and OGSI. Okay, today we have to discuss the overview of practical on OGSA and OGSI. First of all, we have to discuss a practical view of OGSA, Open Grid Service Architecture or Open Grid Service Infrastructure. It is mainly about describing and building a well-defined set of interfaces from which systems can be built and based on open standards such as web service description language. It's nothing but it is an extensible markup language. It often used here. The main objectives of open grid service architecture are to manage resources across distributed heterogeneous platforms, and it supports quality of service oriented service level agreements. The structure of a network of the grids is often complex, but the interactions between or among grid resources are almost invariably dynamic. And it is critical that the grid provides robust services, in the sense strongly good services it provides, such as authorization and access control and delegation. These are the key points of practical view of open grid service architecture and open grid service infrastructure. It provides a common base for independent management, in the sense autonomic management. Here, what exactly the grid contains, in the sense a grid can contain a plethora of resources and along with an abundance of combinations or resource configurations, and it conceivable the resource to resource interactions. Okay, it changing the state and from one state to another state, and it gets the failure modes also. Even the intelligent self-regulation and autonomic management of these resources is highly desirable in this concept of practical view of OGSA and OGSI. Here we want to define open source is a grid. It published interfaces and protocols for the interoperability of diverse resources. And open grid service architecture, it is an open standard managed by a standards body, exploit industry standards, integration technologies, and it leverages existing solutions where it is suitable. So the foundation of open grid service architecture is rooted in web services. For example, we want to take a simple object access protocol and web services description language. These are the major part of this specification. Here, a grid service capability could be comprised of computational resources such as storage, networks, resources and programs, databases and so on. Here, the main key point here, a grid service implements one or more interfaces where each interface defines a set of method how the operation will be performed, that is invoked by constructing a method call through method signature adaptation by using simple object access protocol. Here, in practical view of OGSA and OGSI, there are two important fundamental requirements for describing web services based on the open grid service infrastructure. First one is the ability to describe interface inheritance. In the sense, a basic concept with most of the distributed object systems. And second one is the ability to describe additional information. In the sense, it elements with the interface definitions. This is the overall concept of practical view of open grid service architecture and open grid service infrastructure. Later we discuss detailed view of open grid service architecture and open grid service infrastructure. Thank you.